a world championship is anything but, I would say, pretty incredible, let alone winning several back-to-back. But for one Southwest Florida tennis player, it's like second nature to him. ABC 7's Bailey Smith takes us to the court to meet tennis legend Frank Drilling.
When Fred Drilling looks back on his life, it's hard to count all of the amazing experiences he's had. The 81-year-old tennis pro of Estero has racked up 8 decades worth of memories on the court.
I started playing when I was 3 or 4. My dad played number one for Michigan State University, and I figure he had a racket in my hands when I was that age.
Drilling came back home to Southwest Florida in March with his third straight International Tennis Federation Masters World Championship, winning the 80s and over Gardner Malloy Cup in Turkey.
It's great to be able to play against all the other countries. It's also great to just, you know, you run into old friends. Sometimes you haven't seen them in 50 years.
Drilling goes way back with his team, too. He first played against his current men's doubles partner, Jimmy Parker, when they were just 14 years old. He has accomplishments in nearly every part of the sport, from playing, once being the number one player in the world multiple times in his age bracket, to teaching.
I just enjoy seeing the faces light up with kids when they hit the ball and get it over the net and get excited about that.
Drilling played against Arthur Ashe in college. He was the first women's tennis head coach at FGCU, and he previously owned a tennis shop in downtown Washington, D.C., giving lessons to big names.
I gave some lessons on the White House court, went to Camp David with President Bush, taught a lot of senators and congressmen, so I've been extremely fortunate.
But he's not even close to being done. He's ready to bring on the next age groups.
We're all looking toward the 90s, 95s, and hopefully someday they'll have the 100 and over.
In Naples, Bailey Smith, ABC 7.
Very cool. Thank you, Bailey. Drilling will also compete in the U.S. Open Pickleball Championships in Naples next week.